every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Grace and peace. Good morning to each and every one of you. Welcome to Fresh Start. This is Pastor Daryl Fair. And I want to remind you that Lamentations chapter number 3, verse 23 says that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is his faithfulness to you and I. Every day we wake up, it's a brand new day that God has given to us, full of his grace and full of his mercy. Take a moment, share this morning devotion with someone. Let them know, hey, Fresh Start has started. I don't want you to miss anything that God has in store for you. We've been talking about living a significant life, what it means to live a significant life. We initially asked the question, would you want to be missed or would you want to matter? And then on yesterday, we asked the question, would you do in living your significant life, would you do what you're doing even if you went without recognition? And I think to live a significant life, we don't do it necessarily to be recognized. If that comes, it comes. I think all of us want to be recognized at some point and at some level in our lives. We don't need it every day. I hope we don't need it every week. But some sense of recognition at some point. And I think that's to be expected at some point. I also want to share with some of us that one of the reasons why you live a significant life, but you're not being recognized, is because you do what you do so well, people have gotten used to your excellent service. You do what you do so well that people often take for granted that you do what you do. Now, that doesn't mean that it is okay that it happens. But just because you're not recognized does not mean that what you're doing is not significant. Again, what happens in Ecclesiastes chapter number 9, verses 14 and verse number 15 is there's this battle, this small city. And, I've been thinking about this. Why would a king want this small city? Why would a king even bother with this small city? And yet the city was surrounded, it was seized, but there was a poor wise man in verse number 15. Now there was a poor wise man in that city, and by his wisdom, he delivered the city. Yet no man remembered that same poor man. One of the ways and one of the reasons why we know that you're living a significant life is not because you're being recognized, because sometimes you're not being recognized because you do what you do so well, you know. Have you ever gone into, let me just say this while it's on my mind, have you ever gone into a room, you turn on the lights and you can see, of course, and, you know, that's normal. And sometimes you go into a room and you flip the switch and then boom, the light goes out. Now you weren't expecting that to happen, but now that it did, now your attention is on something that you didn't pay attention to for hundreds of days. You know, you go in the room, flip the switch, boom, the light shines. And sometimes people are so used to your light shining. We'll talk about this tomorrow. Sometimes people are so used to your light shining that the only way that you get full recognition is when you stop shining. Now, I'm not telling you to stop shining. I am suggesting that one of the things you have to be able to do is you've got to be able to do what you do without recognition. But one of the things that he says in the text is that the reason why this man's life is significant, the Bible calls him a poor, wise man, but he used his wisdom. He didn't have the money, because sometimes in our day and time, money is what brings you recognition. Well, he didn't have the money, but he did have wisdom. And we know that the city was delivered because of this poor man. But the Bible says he was a poor, wise man. I hope this is making sense. Poor, wise man. So live your life in a significant way by executing the wisdom that you have. Don't measure your significance by what's in your account. Don't measure your significance by where you live. Don't measure your significance by how well your business is doing, how well your ministry is doing. Don't measure your significance by that. Measure your significance by the wisdom you are able to execute and the results God allows you to have because you are using your God-given gifts and your talents. I told some preachers not too long ago that when you're preaching, it's one thing for the congregation to say amen. But if God doesn't say amen, you didn't really do a significant job. And so just because some people are getting recognized more than others, some have more followers than others, some are selling more than others, some have more degrees than others, don't measure your significance by others and what you don't have that others have. Measure your significance by what God has allowed you to do and the results that you are able to receive. Let me just speak this over your life, and someone help me put it in the chat. I am significant. Put it in the chat area. I am significant. Come on, put it in the chat. It has nothing to do with what's in my bank account. It has nothing to do with the degrees that are on my wall. It has nothing to do with the kind of car that I drive. I am significant because God has given me wisdom. God has given me something to offer the world. And as I offer this to the world or to my community or to my family, it makes a difference, which makes me significant. Take the time, step into this brand new day, knowing you are significant. God willing, I'll see you in the morning. God bless. Gospel, this is the good news.